Okay, so in this video, we'll be using the lookup function to look up a column on a right and return values that are on a left. So again, this is not gonna be a video covering basic VLOOKUP functionality. If you don't know how VLOOKUP works in general, you should go ahead and watch the first part. But this will be about how to get VLOOKUP to check a value in this column and find it, and then return something from the column on the left. So as you may know, VLOOKUP, the way it works, you provide VLOOKUP a table array, and inside of that table array, it's going to only search that value you're looking for only in the first column, and then return something from the right. That's the way VLOOKUP works. Now, in order for us to be able to search a column on the right and then return something from the left, we'll have to actually create a new table in our array that's going to return this column on the left and this column somewhere on the right to that column. And the way we can do that is by using a function called arrayFormula. So, and it's going to be very easy to do this, and it's amazing that it works so well. So if I use arrayFormula function, I'm just going to use it separately to show you what it actually does and what you can get out of it, right? So I'm going to first provide this first column that I want, right? And then I'm going to hit comma. And then I'm going to provide the second column, which should be the next one to the right. I'm simply going to close my parentheses. That's my array formula. Hit enter. And then wrong number of arguments. Oh, silly me. I forgot. Curly braces. Here, or curly brackets, whatever we're calling it. There we are. So now that formula right here, which is, this is the first range on the right, and this is the second range on the left. That will return a new range, as you can see, with this being the first column and this being the second column. Now we can use that in our advantage to create a VLOOKUP function. So I'm gonna start equals VLOOKUP. So the search key is going to be, this is the part number I'm searching for, comma. Now, this is our range or table array, whatever we're calling it. So that's going to be our array formula. And I'm going to open that curly bracket. Didn't forget it this time, apparently. Highlight the first column that I need. This is where I'm searching. I'm going to make sure I press F4. I need to lock that range, comma, and then I'm going to select the second range, which is going to be the second column in our new table. I'm going to press F4 again to lock that, close the curly brackets, and close the parentheses for my array formula. This array formula, if you remember, that's the same array formula I had down there that returns this table in the bottom. And then after that, I'm going to hit comma. Now the next one is our index, the column index. So in this new table that I've created, the name of the product is the second column, so 2. And finally, is this data sorted? Nope, so 0 or false. Close the parentheses, hit enter. Now, again, this is not connected, so I'm gonna delete this one. I was just showing you what's going on, but there it is. Now what we did, we searched through this, we found it, and we return the value. Now, because I locked my ranges, should be able to just copy this down. So this one, 857. And apparently we have a few copies here. It should return only the first one because this is VLOOKUP, right, after all. So there it is. That's that. Now, the same way, we could have returned any other column. So I can replace this B column, which is what I'm currently returning. And decide that, why don't we return the coast? Now you have to make sure that the range matches. So if this is from the third row to the 15th, then this needs to be the same. So I'm gonna go ahead and F4, hit enter, and now we're getting the coast. And that's it. Hopefully you like this video, and I'll see you next time.